Welcome. I come to you during this period of crisis. If you are stoic, as I am, since next to my trading activity, I'm a stoic philosopher. If you're stoic, nothing happened to you. That's how I feel. I feel like if nothing happened, even though three of my speculative positions were liquidated, since my liquidation point is my stop loss point. Even though my hodl position did get hit, I feel like nothing has happened. And even if I look at the technicals, I also feel like nothing has happened. So there's still hope left. And we're going to talk about that. If I find some time, I'll maybe take a look at my tweets too. Depends if I want to do it or not. I'll decide once we get to that point, but we'll start with the charts, since that's what you want to see right now. And so this is not a deep market analysis, not my market update video, but a flash intervention. I'm just going to take a look at a couple of charts with you. Okay, let's jump in. So this is my disclaimer. You right now you can see it, and please read it, so that you are aware that there are always risks involved in trading. And if you need help, if you want to talk to somebody, I'm always there. You can take me for just 1 hour. We can talk about whatever you want, mostly probably Bitcoin, but it can be something else too. Since I'm a philosopher, a stoic philosopher. And if you want more help in deep help, take my special mentorship, where there is a 60% discount right now offer. So that's up to you. You can choose in case you need help. Don't kill yourself because price has dropped. You should never do that. Even if we accept suicide as a solution, don't do it for price dropping. My disclaimer in French and my disclaimer in German. I can help you in French and German too, if you speak French or German. And now let's take a look at the chart. So as you can see, we bounced, and that's really important. And we hold a critical level. On this chart, I put the start of rate one here at 3,585, and we did hold that level. As long as that level holds, we are still in a bull market according to my position. If that level breaks, we are not anymore in a bull market and it's still a bear market. Some people put the start of wave one here. So that's a possibility too at 3K, but I did put it there. And right now it did hold. Wave two can retrace 99% of wave one. So that's what it did and it rebounced. And right now you can see an ABC. So from a technical point of view, this is much more interesting than it was before. It looks more clean. Wave two, but the bemol is that it took too long for the correction. As you can see, wave two was very short. We can compare wave two always to wave four, and wave two was very short here, and wave two was very short here. Here this was the longest, but even then it was nothing compared to what we have right now. Right now it looks like the doubled to this one. So it was extremely long. It was so long that it surprised me. And that was why I was bullish and I was betting for price to go higher, and instead it dropped. And my positions, my speculative positions, did get liquidated. My HODL position would go to zero only if Bitcoin goes to zero. But as you can expect, it's not doing that good. Anyways, so right now, that is very promising, and we talk about why it is that promising. It's because the structure is still intact. For now, according to me, to what I look at Elliott Wave, and I don't care about news. We're going to talk about the news, but I don't care about the news. I don't think that news are that important regarding price. I think that the structure must accomplish itself regardless of news. So this is great. We bounced before my structure was killed, before my structure was annihilated. We bounced. And that's extremely, extremely important. It's the only indicator that did not turn totally bearish. It's my Elliott Wave. All the other indicators are looking really, really bad. We're not going to go over that because I'm not going to do a market update video, a deep dive into Bitcoin. But I know without looking at them that they all turn bad, that they all turn negative. So the only thing that is still positive is what you see right now, is that wave two did not retrace more than the start of wave one. And that means that the structure is still intact. And that's extremely, extremely important because it's the only chance we have of getting a bull market, as I showed you, wave three, four, and five. So for now, everything is fine and nothing happened. And since I'm stoic, even if my structure is lost, it does not matter to me. Because I'm not there just because of the gains. I used Bitcoin as a hedge against the financial market, and it's endless money printing and the risk involved in the traditional finance system. So I took it as a hedge against that. And I know the hedge is not working that fine, but still not as bad as you think, because we're going to compare Bitcoin to the rest and it's not looking that bad. Here you see the bounce and 60 days left to the halving. And here you have it on the 1 day. You see again the bounce, and that could be the bottom of that wave two. I hope it is, because if we go a little lower, then my start of the wave gets taken out and the structure is lost. As I did point you, I did put the start of wave one here. And that will be taken out if we go lower. Some people put it lower, but I put it here, the start of wave one. And if we go lower, and then my structure is lost. But for now, it's intact, and that's really, really important. I can stretch out how much that weight from a technical point of view. Normally, we should close at 7,668 before this week closes on Sunday. Is that possible? Yes, it is possible. Is it probable? No. But we should, because we never, with the growth curve, we never closed below that line. And it is considered broken if you close below it. As you can see, we pierced it sometimes, like here, but we did not close below it. We pierced it very lightly, but we never closed below it. And the thing is that closing below it is extremely negative from a technical point of view. So even here we closed on it, but not below it. And now we are really, we pierced it and we went really deep. And I'm not sure that we can make it to 7,600 before the end of the week. But since I'm an elitician, I believe in the discovery of Ralph Nelson Elliott. That's the most important thing that I found for the markets. I do not, to me, it is not so important that that the growth curve did break or will break, but to a lot of people it is. To a lot of other analysts it is. They will call totally panic once this this growth curve breaks. Here we have Tether, and Tether shows you that money has not left the market, and that's important. It only is moving around. It is moving out of Bitcoin into Tether, but it has not left the market. And as long as it does not leave the market, you should not panic. Now we are taking a look at, I think that's the Nasdaq. No, it's the S&P. And as you can see, the S&P is still looking extremely bad. If you compare it to Bitcoin, Bitcoin looks better because here there's no bounce to be seen. So S&P is still dropping while Bitcoin is bouncing. And it's we are bouncing quite a lot on Bitcoin since the bounce was, let's take a look at how much that was, but it was a lot. That was like 40%, 46%, that's a lot for a bounce, 47%, 46%, that's a lot. So actually I could have pointed on it and it says, 7%, and the candle is 7%. But if you took a long position here, you have 47%. Anyways, it's a lock. Even if the candle even only moved for for 7%, it's a lot. I'm not sure that it's 7%. Anyways. It's a lot if you look, if you compare it to the Nasdaq, which is still dropping. The S&P, which is still dropping. And if you look at the Dow Jones, it's the same story here, we're still dropping. And if we look at Nasdaq, we are also dropping. They look all similar. And even gold is bouncing a little, but not as much as Bitcoin. But then it also dropped less than Bitcoin did. And oil is not looking that good either. So what would be nice is if the markets keep dropping and Bitcoin can keep this level and even start rising. That would be great. That would be the best news that Bitcoin could have, because then we would be a hedge against the crisis and against markets dropping. If we could keep that level and even keep rising, that would be great. That would be the best news we could get. And then we should be on our way for our bull market and to 15, to 50 or even 100K. But if my line in the sand gets taken out, we could be going for 1K. Then it's probable that we go for 1K. we are on extreme fear on the index. And now we are going to talk about the news and about some of my tweets, because I feel like reading you a couple of my tweets. So Plan B says, I don't sell. I hold at least some more years. And I answered, I do the same for my HODL position, but we both will be very poor. Bitcoin was designed against inflation, money printing crises. However, it does not seem to work at all. And as I did post that tweet before the bounce, and now we did get the bounce, so maybe it is working as a hedge against inflation, money printing, and crises. Here I said, if things were as bad, COVID-19 lives for 3 hours in air, everyone would catch it. I don't think the situation is that bad. Transmission cannot be as high. So if when they say that it lives for 3 hours, it is possible that you catch it, but the probability is, in my opinion, low. It's not 100% sure. Just because you sit in a room with somebody with some infected air, you will not for sure catch it. And breathe, you will not for sure catch it. There's maybe a 5% or 1% chance that you catch it, or maybe 10% chance, but not 100% chance that you get it. Next. Power does not have restrictions since money is a thing they create at whim. So the problem with our institution is that they have no limits. They can print as much money as they want, and as long as the system holds, they can go on with whatever they're doing. And that's just what they did. Since the Federal Reserve announced that it would dramatically increase liquidity by injecting as much as $1.5 trillion into the economy with an unprecedented series of asset purchases. So they're going to try to pump the price up, but for now it does not work since the charts keep dropping. The government tells people not to go out. Nobody goes out. We are one step closer to the matrix. This is dystopian. So I answered this a tweet of Jimmy Song, but the tweet did disappear. It does not show up. It should show up, but Twitter is not working correctly. Liquidity crushes monetary contraction. Central banks will try as hard as they can to expend money to combat this. So there's a liquidity crash, so there's a liquidity crisis, and they inject more money in order to counter it. By printing more money and giving it to their friends who need it. So the same system like in 2008 is still on, and nothing has changed. Here I reply to an economist, Philippe Erlin, a French economist, and I said, Philippe Erlin is right. It is a great opportunity to get some cheap BTC before the halving. Because Philippe Erlin said that we should not panic and use the opportunity. Here I answered a tweet from the founder of the Zeitgeist movement, Peter Joseph. And I said, you are quite right, stock market are a childish system of greed and fear. And now I give some recommendation regarding the coronavirus, which I recommend you to take too. We must not become paranoid, but have the right reflexes and take precautions to protect yourself from the coronavirus and others. So there's no use in getting sick and going to the hospital. And if you're elderly, if you're a smoker or obese, you might die. So there's no use in that. So I recommend you following steps, the six steps that I pointed out. One, in a public place, put on a mask. When you are talking to someone, put on a mask. It's a chirurgical mask, so it won't protect you 100%, but it makes the it's still a line in the defense. And if you're sick, you won't. The probability that you infect other people is lower. So I recommend it for your own safety and especially for others in case you get contaminated. So using masks is good. Normally you use them only once, but if you use them more than once because you don't have enough, it's better than having nothing. It makes transmission less easy. Never touch another person. So for me, it's easy because I do the Asian salute. I don't shake hands normally. And right now I'm especially careful of it. But since I don't shake hands, I rarely get sick. Shaking hands makes you sick. And you should not do it. Wash your hands every time you touch a surface that may be infected with the virus. So when you're outside and you touch some buttons or any surface that other people touch, you should wash your hands. A good thing to do is wash your hands when you enter a building or exit a building. Sanitize your hands when you cannot wash them. So there are small bottles with alcohol you can buy or some other disinfectant, and you can use that when you cannot wash your hands. Avoid touching your face when you have touched a surface that may be contaminated. Follow these points and your chance of getting the virus are much lower. And that's good because our medical facilities cannot take too much people getting sick. So there are limited amount of beds. And if you get sick, and they consider that they can't save you, they will let you die because they have no beds to give you. So you should not get sick. You should be extremely careful not getting sick because to slow down the propagation of the virus. If everybody gets sick at the same time, our medical facilities won't be able to care for us. Countries go into quarantine, they do that when they are contaminated. Then it is no longer useful. We should have done it before. So it is no longer useful because there are already people contaminated, people running around in the country. They should have done it before the virus got to us. But I know that it slows the speed of propagation and gives more time to our medical teams to intervene. But you still fall ill. So it takes just more time, but you will still fall ill. Italy has ordered stores, restaurants, bars, and commercial establishments to shut down across the country starting Tuesday. So yesterday. The Italian government just halted economic activity on their entire nation. So that's really bad, and that's why the markets are dropping. Not from a technical point of view, but from a news point of view. I don't believe in news, I believe in technicals. If we go back to, for example, the Nasdaq, I can clearly see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, or maybe 3, 4, and 5, whatever is the case. And now you get an ABC correction. Just because we did hit a 5 that it is correcting an ABC. Okay, but after that, we could the correction could be longer. So I don't know if it's a 5 of a 5 of a 5 of a 5. I don't know how important that 5 is. So I cannot tell you how important the correction will be. But it is bad, especially if we break that level. That would be devastating for traditional markets. And maybe we won't, but it would be devastating. So I believe in technicals less than in news, but still we have to talk a bit about the news since it is that important right now. Here there was some video about disinfection of public facilities against the virus. And here there was an intervention that I listened to. And I said, this is probably exaggerated. Breathing the same air will not always get you sick. If you get coronavirus, it will be mild unless you are old, smoking, or obese. So we just talked about that before. Denmark shuts down schools and universities to fight coronavirus pandemic. People like that tweet, I don't know why. Italy requested the close of all shops and businesses except pharmacies and food stores. We already talked about that. Here is a good video about to know more about the coronavirus outbreak. So I also watch this. This is important, a TEDx talk. Coronavirus in Lebanon, closing restaurant until further notice. One more country that is closing restaurants in until further notice. Here, normally there was an interview with a doctor on the coronavirus in French, but the link did get lost. I don't know why Twitter was not working correctly those last days when I used it, so I'm sorry for that. That the link is not showing up. I just bought surgical masks. The pharmacy sells them 20 pieces for 10 USD. You can use them when you are in public places where there are many people. Keep away, don't touch or kiss people. Otherwise, you risk catching the coronavirus. And that was the last number of the coronavirus. We can look at what it's looking like right now, but it's much worse. So let's take a look. Right now, we have more cases, and especially Europe looks very bad, with France having a lot of cases, Spain, Germany, US, Norway, Greece, and Switzerland. All those countries have a lot of cases. Even Japan, Denmark, Sweden, Netherlands. It is really, really, really a lot of people getting sick. We can look, we take a look at the graphs, and it is still rising a lot. Cases are increasing a lot. And we have now 4,720 deaths. If you look at only Italy, there are also a lot of deaths in Italy, nearly 1,827. And that's a lot of people dying. But not everybody dies. The 1,047 did recover, but nearly the same amount died. So it is looking bad. Switzerland closes border with Italy. They do it late, as always. And that was my last intervention. Is this still a bull market BTC flash intervention? And yet now we have made a new flash intervention. And as I said last time, for now it is still a bull market. I haven't read my tweet for a long time, so I keep on reading a couple of them. But people still like it when the market is in turmoil in decline. So here he was talking about gold, and he said gold is used as fuck. If the shit hits the fan, no one will accept you. Okay, I'm sorry, I just lost my Twitter because my browser did crash. So let's see if I can fix that and reopen a browser for us and move on where we left. So I'm looking at my browser right now, and I share screen so that we get back to it. And here we were. Well, I was reading that tweet. Let's go back to it. Gold is used as fuck. If the shit hits the fan, no one will accept you. No one will accept your yellow metal token, just like they don't accept them now. If the shit hits the fan, it's bullets, food, water, alcohol, and cigarettes. You never see gold handled around in a zombie movie. No, because it sucks. He's right, but people still like it during a crisis. I would like to show you the chart again. Let's reopen the gold chart since my browser did crash. That's why I don't like opening all my charts and showing them to you, because my browser crashes from time. Okay, gold is pumping right now, and that's quite good. Let it pump, and let's hope that Bitcoin will pump too. We can take a look at the rest. I have to move Zoom out of the way. Just seeing if S&P, for example, is pumping too. Or not, because it was not when I last looked at it, but maybe things have changed. No, S&P is still dropping, and it did drop 10% today. Which is really a lot, but gold is doing his job as an hedge since it is pumping, which is good. And Bitcoin is doing the same. Now let's talk about Plan D again. Plan B predicted that March 2020 will close above 8,600. That can still be the case, but it is not that probable. This might be wrong. And he did not say, and he did say that we'll stay above 8,200. So that forecast was wrong. I'm just telling you that because as a consolation, most of the analysts were wrong. I was wrong and most of the analysts were wrong. I did not think that wave two would be such a huge correction because it was already that long. So I did not believe it, and my TA did not help me get out of my position because it was not the top of a five, and I would only exit it at the top of a five. I can open the chart to show you, to illustrate what I mean. Let's do that since it is what I'm talking about. So if you look at my monthly chart again, you see here that we have a 5, okay? And I would exit on the top of that 5, but I would not exit here. And since this is a 4, it should be a 5 too. I put the 5 up here, I can take it down, because I thought we could go higher, but let's take it down. And that would be wave 1. Often, since it is fact, 8 wave works in fractals. So I would exit up there, but I'm not exiting here when I think that wave 2 is ending. So my TA did not help me. Well, now you could say it's an ABC, but I was not sure about that. Here I answered a tweet of Shuatsu Tees. Socrates, I don't know how you say, I think you say Socrates, but you write it as it is spelled. That is an important level that hopefully will hold. And he was talking about the regression curve. And he thinks that it holds. As he said, Bitcoin is testing the adoption curve trend line for the 7th time since 2013. And we are now below it a lot. And I told you that it will be hard getting above it because we should be at 7.6K on Sunday. And I don't think we'll make it. And that was my last video. And I was talking about the longest wave 2 in BTC history. We talked about it again today. Here, I found that funny because they say funny stuff and you can read it. I found it quite funny. And here I'm talking about the quarantine zone in Italy and the coronavirus. And I made a new tweet. Scamcoiner have a diluted mind that cannot detect its worthlessness of the scam coins. So they do not want to recognize that the scam coin is worthless. I look into the past. So I found that video really interesting to see how people were dressing at the time and working well. They looked healthier and clean. But I guess it was not always the case. This one was really interesting about chemistry. Watch it if you have time. And that was funny. Watch it also. I don't think, here he was talking about the Head and Shoulders. I'm not going to read it, but now we dropped that much that I don't think the Head and Shoulders is anyway intact anymore because the right shoulder went much too low. And that was my last intervention. We go 3 back. And here I talked about the politicians that tell you that you can live well in France with 250 euros a month. They lie every time they speak. And that you see how when fear gets people what they do, and don't get masks. And he has spoke about the risk involved in holding Bitcoin. If you download the wrong thing, you lose all your Bitcoin because there was a bad wallet or something like this. That sucks. Even I have to think 3 times before I settle on what to download and from where. How does someone that isn't technical manage to survive? So that's the problem with Bitcoin. Here, people telling you not to touch your face. And here I answered a tweet of Richard Hart, and I think we're going to stop with that tweet. I have read enough tweets for today. The people at the top don't have the same risk you do. The IMF head was found guilty of a 400 million euro fraud and will receive no punishment. If you screw up for $14, you got locked up and throw away the key. And I said, and people think they are respectable and vote for them. Cheating when you are at the top is okay, but don't do it if you are at the bottom. And that's what you're going to see during the crisis. There are a lot of people losing money and they just get a farewell ticket. The society will pay all the debts, banks and so on. Let's see if this crisis gets as bad as the last one and as to 2008 and how they will manage to get out of it. If Bitcoin can be a hedge against the drop in the Nasdaq, if Nasdaq keeps dropping and Bitcoin from here keeps rising, it would be the best news that we could get. If we go, I'm doing my conclusion right now. If you go below that level, 3,585, or even a little lower, around 3K, then it would be devastating and we would be in a bear market and probably go to 1K. Okay, that's all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Don't hesitate, give me a thumbs up and follow me on Twitter if you're interested.